In the heart of historic downtown Quincy sits the city's only rooftop eatery, Alba.
No one has a bigger roof deck than we do. You don't find that anywhere in South Shore.
The roof deck is more than 6,000 square feet, directly atop Alba and its sister restaurant, Zef Sacchetti and Raw Bar. Owner Leo Keika says deck diners can choose bites from both restaurant menus.
The menu is limited to local products and local seafood right now, so we're focusing more and more on seafood as well as, you know, sandwiches and pizzas and some bar food as well.
Tomatoes, peppers, herbs, and spices grow in Keika's garden. He's particularly proud of his tomatoes.
I actually went especially got some seeds in Albania, so we got some great Albanian tomatoes. Basically look like a heart, and they're a little bit more meaty, but not as juicy as regular tomatoes here.
Garden fresh veggies pair perfectly with salads and as herbs season dishes like the swordfish with corn salsa and fresh artichokes.
It's probably the best swordfish I ever had. We only use the center cuts.
And speaking of center cuts, the prime sirloin steak is a customer favorite. That and the bolognese paired with an award-winning red.
We've been collecting wines past 20 years, and we try to pick some of the best quality of wines we think pairs with our food as well as our guests' taste.
Out on the roof deck, it's evident that spritz season has arrived. Keika says diners have been eager to dine al fresco.
We're very limited in space, but we've been very, very busy every single night. So things are coming back.
The northwest suburb of Westford, 35 miles from Boston, may seem an unlikely spot for great Korean food.
Initially, when we started here, it was a little bit of a hard sell.
But 5 years later, Jay Chung and his family have a hit with Seoul Kitchen.
If the community likes you and likes your food, they become quick regulars.
Already equipped with an outdoor patio, Seoul Kitchen added a tent to the mix this summer to expand al fresco seating and keep customers feeling safe.
It's just a great ambiance. It's secluded back from the street far enough where you feel like you're not watching cars whiz by you. And in the back, it's woods, so it's very peaceful.
Here, diners go for traditional Korean cuisine, like the stone pot bibimbap.
Bibimbap translates to mixed rice. We put all the vegetables and the protein on top, as well as a fried egg. And it comes with a side of gochujang sauce, which is becoming really, really popular. I think it's like the next sriracha or something.
But Chung's modern twist on traditional flavors add variety to the diverse menu. Take the avocado ball, Seoul Kitchen's take on nachos. It's filled with spicy tuna and served with a side of tortilla chips. Then there are the Korean tacos.
As delicious beef bulgogi or spicy pork. We call it a fusion dish, but it's all the ingredients we already had.
Chung says once diners get a glimpse of the toasted coconut Mai Tai, everyone wants one. But the blood orange margarita is his favorite.
We do a great tequila. We fresh squeeze our lime juice, fresh squeeze any other citrus that goes in it.
While the restaurant has changed since March, Chung says they're taking it one day at a time.
It's been a challenge, but when you're in the business and you're just kind of working, you're just looking forward to tomorrow.
Jay Chung wanted to find a way to give back. A few years ago, Chung and his family founded the nonprofit Eat to Give. Together with seven partner restaurants, Seoul Kitchen donates $1 to soup kitchens from every specially marked entree they sell. And that is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us, everyone. I'm Anthony Everett. Have a good evening. Hope to see you back here again tomorrow night for another edition of Chronicle. Good night.